2-2 to Mike Beltran for the best beard in MMA.
First in the blue corner,
like the guy from Anthrax.
Weighing 147 and a half pounds, standing 5'7", age 39, from Corona, California. He's fighting for a Geary's fighting system with a record of 9-5-1. This man's a freestyle fighter. Introducing Richard the Juggernaut Schiller. And in the red corner, wearing black, he weighed in at 149 and a half pounds. He stands 5'7", age 30, from Torrance, California, representing VMAZ. With a record of 7-3, this man's also a freestyle fighter. Here is Steve the Dream Magdaleno. Your referee, Louis Cobian.
All right, guys, we went over the rules. Any questions from Blue? Red, shake gloves. Good luck to you.
As you said, we moved to 3 5-minute rounds now with this fight. Here we go, first round of action. The Dream, Steve Magdaleno, black trunks, all white with some black trim. The Juggernaut, Richard Schiller. This is one of those fights, if somebody asked me to pick two guys I'd like to see square off that aren't household names yet, but I think would be a great matchup, this is it.
Yeah, definitely. Like we said before, two seasoned grapplers, not just pure jiu-jitsu guys. Guys with some good wrestling, some takedowns, some clinch work.
Athletic and also good cardio. Tough guys.
They're in on the clinch here.
In case you forget who's who, Schiller written right on the back of his trunks right there.
They make it easy for you sometimes. You know, that's what I like about the boxers. They always have the last name on them.
On the trunks.
Over-under position for both guys. Magdaleno circles out. Back to the center of the ring. Right hand lands with Magdaleno. Jab by Schiller.
This is part of what I expected to see with two of these guys that have a good grappling pedigree was the striking battle. Now, while visually Schiller might have the better beard, let's see what happens if they start trading shots.
I wonder if that's an advantage, having that big goatee. Maybe pushing the blow a little bit?
Only on an uppercut, maybe. If it sweeps it up like a mud flap, maybe. But both of these guys can take a shot. I've seen them both fight before more than once. I've called both of their fights before, as have you. It's an interesting thing if it turns into a striking battle for me, because I've seen both of them do that too. They will brawl.
Locking for position here, corner of the ring.
Thigh from Schiller, return to the midsection by Magdaleno.
Really a game of inches here, this clinch game up against the ring. Both guys looking for a little opening. All he needs is a little bit of space to land a strike.
A little
moving
sneaky uppercut
for a takedown or a sneaky uppercut, just like that.
Yeah, Schiller got him backing up. That is where the protect yourself at all times logo comes in, or slogan rather, right there. Combination punching now from Magdaleno. Magdaleno's striking has gotten sharper, too. That's why I'd be curious to see if he's able to unfold that here.
Single leg by Schiller. Stuff with Magdaleno.
Magdaleno had a fight not that long ago in Long Beach. Since his last appearance at Pandemonium 5. And I'd seen him evolve as a fighter. I'd seen him doing some stuff that he hadn't been doing before and not doing some stuff that he had that he probably needed to shake. And that could be making some of the difference in this fight, because I think the old Magdaleno would have had more trouble with Schiller than he's having.
Well, he's doing a good job of making sure he's winning the clinch battle, pushing the other guy against the ring. You always want to be the guy on the outside. You look good to the judges. It looks like you're pushing them. You have more space to go for takedowns. Right hand lands. Both fighters swinging now in the corner of the ring. Schiller turns it around. Now he has Magdaleno's back against the corner.
There are explosive pockets of striking that goes on between clinches. You get the feeling that somebody might land the magic shot during that time. So far, first round of action, Again, Schiller in the white with black trim, mostly black with a little red trim there.
So much for that ground battle we thought we were going to see. So far, it's been all striking and clinch work.
Like you said before, sometimes when two guys have the same weapon going in, one cancels out the other.
Well, Schiller's gone for some takedowns, and Magdaleno's done a good job of defending him.
I think that falls under that category of what you said, because of if he didn't have the same pedigree, he wouldn't be able to stop the takedown.
Whoa, two really good right hands by Magdaleno land. Schiller unfazed, though.
Magdaleno will take a shot to get a few in, and he's able to take shots to land them. Interesting, the crowd almost following the fight on cue, like when it quiets down, it goes into a clinch, the crowd quiets down. Of course, the more exciting moments get the crowd amped, but it's very well choreographed.
Have they done this before?
Yeah. 10 seconds left in the opening round. Schiller and Magdaleno. Going to end this one strong.
Oh, Schiller with a flurry at the end. Maybe that might be enough to steal the round. Very close competitive round by both fighters. Magdaleno doing a little bit of a better job winning some of the strikes. A lot of those really good right hands that Magdaleno landed. Schiller going for some takedowns. None of them successful. Interesting first round to start off the co-main event.
Yeah, and you saw that it was the heated exchange as the bell rang. Schiller gave a little bit of a shove right after they finished throwing shots, and Magdaleno just turned and walked away because he understood what was happening. It was the heat of the moment, kind of caught in what was going on thing. Didn't take it personal.
Vladimir Matyushenko in the corner of Magdaleno, I'm sure, gave him some good advice. Likely something to do in that clinch. Probably saying, keep throwing that right hand because you're finding your mark.
Schiller choosing to stand up in the corner. No stool.
A lot of times, you know, fighters don't want their legs to kind of, you know, swell up, fill with blood, kind of get start building up their fluid, so they'll stand.
Close first round. Now we go into the second. The Dream, Steve Magdaleno in the black, in the mostly white trunks. The Juggernaut, Richard Schiller. Two very well matched fighters. And a close opening round.
See, a lot more movement by Magdaleno. Schiller's kind of just standing there. Right in front of us, head kick and punches, some of them get through for Magdaleno.
That's some of the evolution of Magdaleno I was talking about. I seen the improvement in his striking game the last time I seen him fight.
A lot of head movement by Magdaleno. I think he's managed to avoid a lot of strikes by Schiller using it. But now an errant strike by Magdaleno gives up his back to Schiller. Not a place to want to be. One hook standing. This is where Schiller goes with this.
This is an interesting turn of events because that is not where anybody that fights Richard Schiller wants to be.
Turns out of it. Now he's got the clinch. Pushing Schiller against the corner.
Very close contest so far.
Right hand lands, Magdaleno.
Those strikes could be making the difference on the scorecards right now. The clinches, I think, is a little bit closer of who you could score as winning the fight. However, the striking battle seems to be going a little bit more to Magdaleno.
Yeah, definitely landing the more powerful strikes. More active as well. Although Schiller's landing some good jabs as well. Good leg kick lands by Magdaleno. Tried to kind of throw a strike into a takedown. Magdaleno wise to it, stops it. Magdaleno's got a pretty deep clinch here. Should be able to do something with it if he so chooses. Got a body lock. Rasp his hands, maybe dive or go a little lower for a double leg maybe.
And Magdaleno backed into the corner by Schiller. It's the dynamic moments that may win over the judges because a lot of the fight is close. There's an ebb and flow that really isn't putting the momentum in anybody's corner right
now. Yeah, when the flow is kind of in neutral, you know, those little spikes that judges remember.
Yeah. Second round of action here, Pandemonium 6, Magdaleno and Schiller. a lot of quiet, followed by Storm, followed by quiet, followed again by Storm between these two guys.
Magdaleno now working some strikes in with that clinch. We're seeing his good head position. See Magdaleno putting his forehead kind of under the chin of Schiller in the forehead. Once you have dominant head position, there's almost nothing your opponent can do. He can't go for takedowns. A lot of the strikes aren't really there. Head position is a very underrated part of the clinch game. No head position here at this moment, but good turnaround here by Magdaleno. Nope, still up against the ring.
You can actually see Magdaleno processing possible outcomes and choices.
This is where Magdaleno excels, not in the clinch, but in the pocket up against the ring. That's where he's really been excelling. Now Schiller turns it on, lands some good strikes.
Yeah, Schiller got the better of that exchange. Magdaleno only avoided a percentage of it because of his head movement. But I don't think Schiller took any damage in that exchange at all that time.
And no one's really dominated the clinch, but once Magdaleno kind of breaks the clinch, throws a strike as he does it, stays in the pocket within striking range, that's where he does his most damage. Let's see if he does it here.
Yeah, that might have been the first exchange that he didn't really dominate between them on that.
Backs all the way away. Yeah, very quickly. I'm wondering why he didn't keep Schiller up against the cage and throw strikes, but back into the center of the ring.
Second round of action, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Jabs by Schiller. Three jabs, four jabs all in a row. Find their mark for Schiller.
Schiller winced like his knee had hurt him for a second. Eats a right hand over the top from Magdaleno. Throws an uppercut.
Oh, right hand! George Schiller! Schiller's down, and that's it! That right hand found its spark all night, and it found its spark for the last time. Knockout win, Magdaleno.
Two guys who came in here with a master's degree in grappling, and we got ourselves a good old-fashioned knockout.
We were saying that right hand for Magdaleno was finding its mark. But once he got an angle...
At 4:43 of the second.
Once Magdaleno got that angle, once he came off to the side a little bit, he was able to land that strike, not flush straight into the chin, but off to the side and kind of twist that head around. That's how you do a lot of damage, right on the chin at an angle. And we saw the
finish right there.
The wares of his victory right there.
Make no mistake about it. If you don't know Richard Schiller, he's not an easy guy to put down. He got caught. Magdaleno goes to 8-3 now. Schiller will go to 9-6. That's what you gotta love about a fight like this. Again, two guys took a fight that was risky for both of them.
It was a good matchup for both fighters. Both these guys, you know, pretty equal in experience. Both with similar skill sets. Magdaleno had a major knee surgery not long ago, and we see he's recovered nicely from it. His cardio looked good, didn't like his knee buckled at any point.
Matt George in the corner of Magdaleno giving him a recap. Schiller's knee hurts him. Yeah, that's what I was saying, that just before the exchange against the ropes, he looked like he was wincing from his knee. That may have been a distraction for him. That might have contributed in part to him getting hit clean. However, take nothing away from Magdaleno. He was intending to do what he did.
Yeah, I always say that right hand kept finding its mark. Not its mark for the last time. Closing seconds of round number two. KO win. Steve Magdaleno.
The dream that is Magdaleno becomes a nightmare for Schiller. And a cool thing to see too, because again, I said I've seen Magdaleno evolving as a fighter. I've seen him improving from Pandemonium 5, the fight he'd had since then, specifically the one at Long Beach Fight Night when he won by KO. I'd seen some stuff when I watched that fight where you could see improvements.
Ladies and gentlemen, before I
Before I announce this winner, let's have a round of applause for these fighters. Great fight. Well, fight fans, this fight came to an end. 4 minutes, 43 seconds of round two. Your winner by knockout. In the red corner, Steve Magdaleno. And also a big...